lo que
la ando en la chiquita bien criado, corriendo la evolución en conmigo, acelero el evolución bien mal criado, de show mi revolución en conmigo, ando en la chiquita bien criado, corriendo la evolución en conmigo, acelero el evolución bien mal criado, de show mi revolución en conmigo, con dos cilindras de turbo lo sigo paseando. El Evolucho lo deja babeando, marcando 9 segundos de calle. No saben que este carro está de calle.
Falco,
lo dejo bici, bici.
Tú sabes, este carro está de magazine.
Arrancando, toma este buen carril. Se dan paso que vengo como un
Muy buenos días. Muy buenos días, querida fanaticada. Bienvenidos. Bienvenidos una vez más a este tu programa de todos los sábados, Revoluciones por Minuto, cuando una vez más estamos revolucionando el mundo. Bueno, un aplauso para todos nosotros aquí en la estación. Muy buenos días, Alex, ¿cómo te encuentras?
Vamos muy bien, estamos trabajando fuertemente para recordarles que nos pueden escuchar en nuestra aplicación totalmente gratis para todos los dispositivos y nos pueden encontrar como Viva FM Orlando.
Así es. Buenos días, Bombi, ¿cómo te encuentras?
Buenos días, everything good.
Ok, that bueno, good. Señoras y señores, estamos comunicables a través del 407-260-0000. We are through. Yeah. What's the number, Bambi?
407-260-0000 or exactly. 260-0000.
Exactly. Also, we are through 95.5 FM. Also, 10:30 a.m. Mm-hmm.
Magda y Torino on Facebook.
Facebook Live. Uh-huh.
Or vivafmorlando.com.
Exactly. Oh, oh, wow. It's a flash. Or racingcmac.com. Oh, at the end, in YouTube. Remember, we are in YouTube. Bueno, mi gente, en el día de hoy, pues les traigo un show muy ameno, ¿verdad que sí? Vamos a estar hablando de muchísimas cosas importantes en el día de hoy, como es el coronavirus, el calendario de eventos, que les tengo una gran sorpresa, lo que queda del calendario de eventos. También vamos a estar hablando, tenemos una gran entrevista con este gran corredor campeón, ¿verdad que sí? Carl Brunet, así que usted no se lo puede perder, va a estar con nosotros también. We are, and also, Bombi in English, you'll say that because I know he's listening.
Yeah, we're going to have a good guest, a great guest today, Carl Brunet.
Okay,
the man with the plan. He'll be with us today on the radio here.
Exactly. You cannot miss that interview, okay? And that's going to happen at 11:15.
Okay.
Today.
Don't
at 11:15. Okay, so you're not going to miss that great interview. Also, we're gonna talk about those Veneno. We're going to talk about NHRA. She race or not race? I have the answer for you also. Festival de la Salsa, también. I got something to say, all right? We got an interview also with Ed Núñez. With that great man. So, a lot of things happening. Come on, Bambi. Cheer
Everything
up.
Everything good.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my God. Recuerda, maneja con precaución. Vamos a estar hablando de las carreras ilegales. Y les voy a estar hablando de lo que sucede al momento en California, una ley que acaban de pasar, bueno, hace ratito que la pasaron, así es que si usted está pendiente, no se va a perder esta gran información que le tengo
también,
en el día de hoy.
Y aquí también.
Ok, sí.
Detallitos, sí.
Así es que
muchas
sorpresitas para esos que siguen manejando ilegalmente en la calle. Bueno, chicos, vamos a un corte comercial.
Yeah, we'll be back.
Lo que diga Luis.
Ok, vamos. Sí, vamos. Ok, we're going. We'll be back, okay? Don't go away.
Al Pizza no solo tiene la más famosa y auténtica pizza estilo New York, sino que también preparan sabrosos sándwiches y calzones. También puede hacer su orden por teléfono. Llame a Rubén al 407-935-0063. Localizado en el 1107 Bryan Street, en Kissimmee, donde le darán el servicio que los han hecho famosos.
¿Quieres tener un cabello saludable, resistente y libre de roturas? Gloria's Hair Salon se preocupa por la salud de tu cabello. Ofrecemos tratamientos para eliminar caspa, grasa, picazón y caída del cabello. Profesionales en la belleza, estética, manicure, pedicure, uñas acrílicas, queratinas orgánicas y tratamientos antifrizz. Recuerda, tu cabello respira, dale oxígeno. Estamos ubicados en el 9645 East Colonial Drive. Haz tu cita hoy, 407-275-6494. Gloria sea el salón donde la estrella eres tú.
¿Nunca le revisaste el aceite?
Piensa para adelante, piensa en Advance. Llévate un paquete para cambio de aceite Freedom to Choose a $25.99 en Advance Auto Parts.
Where does your inspiration come from? What you see? What you hear? Or where you go? Find your inspiration in the reimagined Mazda 3 hatchback.
Iturrino Photo Studio, sus fotógrafos profesionales para bodas, ocasiones especiales y todo tipo de actividad. Se producen portfolios de modelos y calendarios. Para precios competitivos, favor llamar al 407-694-2654. Contamos con artistas gráficos para diseñar tarjetas de presentación, flyers de actividades, promociones y mucho más. 407-694-2654. Iturrino.com.
Mi gente, quédate ahí con nosotros. Este es el residente Calle 13 y estás escuchando Revoluciones por Minuto. Aquí, Calle 13, se vale todo, todo.
Muy buenos días, querida fanaticada. Bienvenidos, a otro show más de Revoluciones por Minuto. Y yo tomo la iniciativa hoy de decirles a todos nosotros, ¿verdad? Porque me incluyo myself. Happy birthday to me, ¿ok? Porque, señoras y señores, cumplimos 18 años en Revoluciones por Minuto y lo cumplimos en marzo 6, así es que estamos un poquito, ¿verdad? Muchísimas cosas han pasado, pero el mes, todo el mes de marzo vamos a estar celebrando, pues, que estamos aquí en Revoluciones por Minuto por 18 años. Come on, Bombi. We have to celebrate. This is great. Ok, tú sabes que esto no lo aguanta mucha gente. No mucha gente aguanta estos 18 años y yo les voy a... Vamos a comenzar, Bombi, primeramente por el público, que es el que siempre, ¿verdad que sí? Y Luis Felipe, sí, dime algo.
Yo no sé, pero yo estoy explotado de estos 18 años.
Bueno, muchísimas cosas han pasado. Yo no me estoy escuchando bien.
Yo no
espérate.
Puedo ni ponerme en cámara ya.
¿Por qué?
De lo explotado que estoy.
Bueno, yo estoy muy contenta porque son 18 años de mucha, de trabajar duro, de altas y bajas. Y pues muchísimas cosas han pasado por nosotros, ¿verdad? No todo el mundo es perfecto, pero... Oh, God. Pero estamos celebrando. Vamos a continuar hablando con ustedes, pero we have somebody on the line, Bombi.
Yeah, hello.
Hello. We have somebody, but we need to receive this person in the very special way with a lot of applause.
Okay.
No. But yeah, do we have those? No. No. But we're gonna do it like this. We're gonna stand up. Let's stand up. Stand up. Oh. And I say. Welcome to Car Brunette. Okay.
Thank you.
Car Brunette, the
okay.
man.
Okay, he's. I know. I'm glad. I hope you're looking. You know, right here because we give you a good. You know.
Welcome.
Welcome, right here at the radio station. Okay, but Carr, oh my God, man, everybody, you did it, and we are so proud of you, we are so proud of your team, but this is, people, they don't believe,
yeah,
they don't believe what happened to your four cylinder, and go yeah. to where you are right now, so this is so amazing, but we're going to start that you have a long way. You went, you came to Orlando, and you raced, and a lot of gassets, and a lot of people talk, and then you went home, right? And yep. then after that, you came back.
And then you got the world record.
You came back with more energy than ever before, okay? And yep. and then you show something to the world. Tell me.
Yeah, but as you know, we work very hard on that. And okay. yeah, we show to everybody we can go in 5 seconds. For us too, it's unbelievable. We didn't think we gonna run fast like that, and now it's happened. So we see how this four cylinder can make some good run at the quarter mile, and we know we can go faster a little bit more than that. So it's unbelievable. It's unbelievable for us too.
No, it's unbelievable for everybody. I mean, you did it. You got the 5 seconds. And Carl, I have a question for you. No billet, right?
No, not billet right now. We have something new to try it before. We have, for sure, we of the inside of the engine, something we have a long stock and long big thing inside. But it's not a real billet block, you know.
Okay.
So and now they still. You still take around 82 pounds of boost. It's still pretty good, you know.
Oh, and so, you got small turbo still, right? No big turbo, small turbo, right?
No big turbo, 88. We want to stay in the rule. Because I want to stay around modified class, you know, because it's my class. I'm not a GTD.
Okay.
I can never, for sure, can run a 560 with that. So never I can catch a 2GZ with that. But I'm a modified class. I have a 4-cylinder car, so I want to stay in the class, so. I don't want to go over. We are maximum right now. We are the maximum of the boost. And the last time, as you see last weekend, we run a 604, 60, 595 with the 64. With the 604, it was during the day, and the maximum boost we can make it is 80. At the night when we make the 604, we win 83. And the night after was the air was very good, and the air was very very cool. So we make around. 84, 85 pounds of boost. So we see right now we have the maximum of the boost. We have to play at the other place in the car, play with the trainee, play with the gear ratio. We have to see something else if you want to go faster.
Oh, and you're still with the 7-speed transmission, right?
Well, yeah. It helps a lot at the end of the track because we can put more gear ratio and something like that to go faster at the end. And it's still pretty good. We're running a small clutch. So with the small clutch, when you have lots of gear, it's lots better for the clutch.
And what about the weight of the car? Are you still in the weight limit?
The weight of the car right now is 2075 with me in. And we are in the maximum. We cannot remove some weight in it. Right now we remove all the weight as we can. If you see, we put some carbon wheel bar at the back on the last event. And we remove all the weight that we can put out of the car right now. So we can never... go under on that point right now and 2075 pounds
so,
in the car.
I have a question. I know you came back here. I know you have a lot of, you have a racetrack over there where you can race. Did you were thinking that you, when you came to Orlando, you want to touch those 595, you know, belong to the fastest four cylinder in the world?
yeah. Me, I like to go around Orlando because I can run a quarter mile in my place. We're running Pro Mod, but with the Pro Mod, we only race on the 8 mile.
Oh,
so the track is not ready for run that on that speed every time during the summer. And I know when I'm going to Orlando, I know the track is very good. And the last time was one of the best event I've ever seen in my life. So I know that was the time to go fast because all the magazine, everyone was there to see all the good big name, and everybody was there to see that event. So it was that we make it at the good time last weekend, you know, because right now everything is stopped and we don't know what's gonna happen, but we make the good time at the at the good time.
Definitely you came in the right moment, in the right race, you know, because the fastest car in the world, they raced right there, that specific that day. And then you take advantage and you show the world that you can do it. You know, you came from Canada and you can do it. And we are so proud because we never see a four-cylinder, right?
Yeah, five-second
touch
run.
Belong to the five-second car. So, my God. So what is your expectation right now?
Oh, God, when is the expectation? I don't know. I don't know what is the limit right now. We're going to try to go faster for sure as possible. I think I can go in 580, but 580 what, I don't know. But I'm pretty sure I can put on the board 589 or something like that. That's over 235 miles per hour.
Okay.
So to what expectation, we don't know. But for sure, we can go faster than that.
Oh, that's incredible.
Oh, my God.
No billet, right? No billet.
No billet. But the head billet is coming. We have something to try, but we never tried the head billet.
Okay.
Going to be better? I don't know, because right now we are the maximum of the bow. So if we put something better... something billet, but we cannot put more boost. Probably they got to change nothing, but something is right. We broke nothing at the end of the track, and I can make all the weekend without broke nothing. That's the good thing of the race right now. And with my engine, we broke nothing. We broke no flush, no head gasket. We on the last year we worked hard in the head gasket to try to put more boost. And me and my mother tell, when you're going to put 80 pounds of boost, we go in the 5 seconds. And what we do on the last weekend.
Wow. That's unbelievable.
That's a lot of boost.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, that's the way to do it. I mean, they know the way. You know, you got to do it. Either run or blow up. You're doing good.
Yeah. Before we have our time with that. But now I think we found the problem to make all the power that we can put on the engine and on the car. So we have a good car too, and my brother work hard in suspension and everything to go fast. And they don't have any trick, you know. We have to go at the track and make some tests. Us, we can like you see on the last 3 months, I go 3 times at your place, and but I like that too. It's like a holiday when I go there, so I like that. But they have no trick. We have to make some race. We have to make some tests. Try a new thing. Us, every time we're down the track, we change something in the car, put new clutch or play with the suspension. So that's why we can make a 92 60 foot. You know, we go.
You win 92.
Like a pro mod, like a fuel dragster, the 60 foot of that car is amazing too.
Yeah. Man. What type of motor you have right now? Because sometimes a lot of speculation people talk too much. You know what I mean.
Yeah. But it's the type of, so that engine is that a GM engine, a Ecotec engine, like a Cobalt. That's a 2.1 liter, is 135 cubic inch. And we still have right now the OEM head and the OEM block. Lots of things change in it for sure, but nothing bullet right now.
Inside the turbo? The size of the turbo?
Size of the turbo is 88 millimeter.
Oh my God.
Garrett, oh, jeez.
The generation 2. So now the generation 3 is coming.
Yeah.
So Garrett just put new. So probably with that one, you can go, you can get put more boost. I don't know. You have to try it.
Yeah.
The Fortel is going to be better. But I know with that turbo right now, it's still pretty good, Garrett. And 88 millimeter.
Yeah.
So the weight of the car is 2075, just saw before with a 7-speed trainee. So now we just have a new sponsor just jump with us this week. We're going to put some Bunny Fenty clutch. So we're going to play with that guy too. We're going to put the same clutch as a pro stock. So it's going to be a little bit bigger. So we're going to see if it will be better than the last time we're going to go on the track.
I believe and I think that you're going to be the fastest four-cylinder for a while.
Definitely.
I think so.
Because
I know
because you know what?
Good. They're gonna push the other guy to go faster too.
Yeah.
So I know the other guy fast. That jet racing, the guy from Brazil.
Yeah.
He's gonna try to push hard a little bit more. So it's good for that too. You know.
Exactly. But Carr, what I'm trying to say is people been trying this for so many years, you know, and never touch those.
yeah,
you know, numbers and have that type of results. And, you know, I hear people, oh, he came from Canada and he made it. Of course, you made it, but you work a lot. You, you know, you tried a lot and you show the world that you can do it. That's that's the only thing, you know?
He shut up a lot of people. Carl Burnett shut up a lot of people.
Oh, my God, yeah. And people still... You know, I found people that say, Magda, I can't believe it. I can't believe it. And he did it, and he showed what he had to show.
Old car, 0.92, 60 foot. You have a lot of new cars don't go 92, 60 foot.
Exactly. You know, I have a guy here. His name is Manuel Martin. He says, very proud to be in this team. Good interview, my friend.
Manuel Martin.
Yeah. Maybe you know him. And another people, other people said that you are a coronavirus from Canada.
He got everybody sick.
Yeah, you got everybody sick. So.
Yeah. You know, a lot of people, you know, he's been through a lot. Some people, you got to change the turbo. You got to do the weight of the car. You got to change this. You got to do that. And he never gave up. And look at the results now.
Hey, Carl, let me ask you another question. This is kind of a personal question, but hey, I had to ask you. How much money you spend, let's say, then in that weekend?
Too much money.
just give me a couple numbers. I don't know.
I like to go to race in Florida. To me, is cost around $3,500 US only for the hotel, the gas, and the truck,
and the
food and everything, you know, and the screen trim at the door. So it's $3,500 US. So it's like around 5,000 Canadian right now. $5,500 Canadian to go there. So yes, they cost lots of money to go there. But like I would say, it's like I go in the. I go anywhere in the world within vacancy. It costs me with my family that kind of money. So I go there 1 week with my friend and everybody. So we are two to paying, me and my brother. So we work we work for that, you know, because
you
like
it.
That. We love that. We love that drag racing. We win our life with that. You know, my brother work only at the track, and he make drag racing all the summer long. So we race a couple of times at my place with the car. But when I go to Orlando, when I go race out there at my place, it's like a holiday for me. So
I like to go there.
I know they cost us money during a year. They cost me a lot of money. I don't really look right now, but we are playing. My father helped me a lot, too.
Yeah.
So we are all the family. I'm not only alone to pay for that. We are three. Three people to pay for that is not too bad too. It's not the same thing. Somebody have a boat, somebody have a snowmobile, or somebody have some motorcycle. They have a 2-3 home. Us, we have a drag racing car, so we have the fastest one. So
You're gonna be for a long time, believe me.
Oh no! Hey, Max Fortino, he say it's a 4-cylinder Canada virus. Canada virus. that's good.
Yeah,
you know,
he's got everybody sick.
Yeah, I know. So
he's doing good. They're doing good. There's teamwork, family team, and let me just translate a little bit in Spanish. Para esa gente que está escuchando, Carl, le hicimos la pregunta. Él dice que se gasta más o menos $3,500 de aquí de los Estados Unidos para venir a la pista y a dar y pasarla bien con su familia en un evento.
Exactly.
So le cuesta también a él. But you guys are doing good, Carl, and I know with these changes, the car's gonna go faster. Believe me.
Yeah.
But don't go too fast. Don't try to be an airplane.
I don't have to go too fast because gonna put me out for sure.
Yeah. You don't want that no more.
Exactly.
A lot of people are gonna complain. You know, everybody has to thank you for what you're doing and your family. You know, and there's a lot of negative people out there. And to me, you guys are doing good with what you have, and you know that's what counts. Everybody runs what they can, and they sell all the parts all over the world. So anybody could do it. Yeah. You just gotta have a good team and get it going.
Yeah. Don't forget the best important thing is to have fun when you got the respect.
Yeah, exactly.
One winner and one guy is faster. So the one thing I always said, when you're at the racetrack, you have to have some fun. And when you have some fun and the party is there, when you are at this point, you can continue and have some fun with your friends.
Exactly.
That's part of it. It's also the race car, but it's teamwork and family at the track. Have a good time.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what counts.
So
I always said that's the most important thing. So like the Puerto Rican, they are all there with all his family.
Yeah,
the car's always clean and everything. So
yeah,
that's what I see when I go at the race. So I think it's very important.
Yep, it's all teamwork and everybody's family there. That's what you want. Everybody helps out each other. You know, and that's good. But I know you're going to be fast for a long time. One of the fastest.
But the other guy, I'm pretty sure they're going to try to push hard to where you don't have a choice. You cannot sit in my back right now. We have to continue to evolve and try new things. It's like everybody has to try something else new every time. When you stop to evolve, when you stop to put some new thing,
yeah,
is at the point you stop to go faster. So like everybody, you have to go faster. You have to try every time. Sometimes it's working, sometimes it's not working. But
they work for you. It worked for you.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
It worked for you. You guys did good, excellent. I mean, I still can't believe it.
Yeah.
A lot of people can't believe it, but it's there. It happened. Fast. Yeah. Yeah. You guys couldn't believe it, right? I mean, it was coming, but you know. Is oh man, when you see the time, when you see the ticket, what do you think? You couldn't believe it?
When it was at the end of the track and some guy told me he goes 5 seconds, yeah, you were sure. The minimum guy was there, showed me the time slip, and then his colleague was pretty fast. I was very happy about that. And my brother said that when he arrived, the car's still working.
Yeah.
I said, yes, okay, let's go for the next round. So we are very happy. My brother and all my team, that's amazing for us too. So.
No, that's very a very good moment for you guys. You guys did it, man. Yeah. I mean, all over the world, everybody knows. Carl Burnett, the man.
Knows.
Yeah.
That's what I said just before. We are at the good time.
Yeah.
At the good place, at the good moment, too. So everybody was there to see that. So I know they don't have too much important that event. But I know me. It was good for my sponsor. It was good for see my car. Everybody see my car in the world right now. So I think it was pretty good. I don't have no choice. Me and my brother said, don't have choice to go at that event. That's why I'm running Top Sportsman, because the only class for me at this place right now. So before to go there, I called to Wade, and I said to Wade, I want to make quarter mile during the qualification. Just come to make your 5 seconds. So I was very happy when you see that. So that tell me that. So that's why we go at Orlando that time to shoot the car all the world around. So.
Okay.
You guys work very hard. Yeah. Let me tell you, very, very hard.
Bumby,
you finally did it.
Bumby, we have Ed Nunez on the line also right there. Ed, welcome. Welcome to Radio RPM. We have on the line with you, Carl Burnett. Okay?
Hey, what's up, guys? How are you doing today?
Good. Carl, you listen to him, right?
Yeah, okay. Man. That's one bad dude. I've told him personally a couple times. I love the way that, you know, they have a small team, and everywhere they go, they terrorize the competition. So I really admire the stuff they've done. They've done a lot of impressive work out there on the track.
Yeah, they do. They shake in the block, believe me.
And they and he shakes the world. That's the way, you know, to show that
he's a great driver
and he's
teamwork.
Looking for the best.
Teamwork.
So, Ed, what do you think about that? About those 595?
No, I think it's crazy. You know, I think a couple of years ago, you know, when the 2JZ started running 5 seconds, everybody was like going crazy. And now that a four cylinder is running 5 seconds, I think it's absolutely incredible how much power you can make with a relatively small engine compared to a lot of these VA guys that, you know, have much more cubic inches, and it's impressive. I mean, and I know that they recently switched over to Fuel Tech, which is also one of my sponsors, so I can't say I'm too surprised that they've been able to really fine-tune their combination to the level they have using such a sophisticated ECU.
Mm-hmm.
Car.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
Yeah,
he's got it. He's got it. They got it down packed. They got it down packed. I see more in the car, and I see more broken records.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's gonna happen, Carl. Oh my God, you
guys
did it.
Let him race against the imports this year. I know that's always been a touchy subject.
Yeah, let's see what happens.
Don't get too scared.
Yeah, let's see what happens. Well, you know how it is. You have the politics of the weight, the turbo, this, that, everything changes. I mean, you run with what you got, and I don't know. You know how it is in the sport.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, so far, no matter what rules they put on these guys, they've always found a way to overcome them. So
yeah. Oh,
the competition better get ready.
Oh, yeah, they're coming for more. Believe me, with all those changes and the big turbo and the billet and everything else, it's coming.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
They better be ready.
Okay, Carr, just say goodbye to all these people who's watching you all around the world. And Ed, stay right there. So we're going to continue with Ed. Carr.
Yes, thank you, everybody. You're my fan and look me in. Thanks to my family, all my sponsors. And thank you at the radio too to make me a good interview every time. So I like that. I like to speak to all the people when the people would come at my trailer. So I like to speak to everybody. So thank you to everybody and look me again to try to go faster again.
Okay.
We're always proud of you.
We wish you good luck. Okay. And next time you have to be here with me, next to me. So it's a promise.
I'm gonna try to make that, no problem.
Okay.
Thank you, Carl. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye. Hey, Ed, we're gonna continue with you, okay? So what's going on, man? I know a lot of things happening. Are you there?
Absolutely. So we've been working pretty good in the corner. We're getting ready for a really big race that they're going to have in South Georgia, in Valdosta.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
They're actually doing a $500,000 to win bracket race in mid-April.
Okay.
So it's the biggest race that I've ever been to. Basically, it's going to be the best of the best bracket racers on the planet are going to be there, trying to get that big prize. So we've been doing a lot of testing with the Lexus, trying to get it to the point where it's as consistent as possible because, to show up to a race like that, having a consistent car is not an advantage. It's a requirement.
Yeah.
You know? Right. And then the driver needs to step up and then, then you just got to see what happens. But, we've been doing some testing with some the bracket radial tires from Mickey Thompson. We've been doing some tuning on our fuel tech to try to really get the car dialed in. And just competing more against the V8s rather than focusing so much on racing the import guys, just because the league with the V8s tends to be a little bit more higher level of competition. It's a lot tougher to win there.
Yeah.
So that's where we've been practicing a lot with them and trying to get ready as much as we can for the big one.
Oh, wow. That's fantastic.
No. And Nunez is a hell of a driver.
I know. Man, you always show. You always have people, shaking and asking, why he always win? Why he always get something, So it's because you work a lot, and you know what you're doing and you focus on something and you do it.
They're breed of champions,
Exactly.
It's a matter of, dedicating the time to the car. Like, people, I think, underestimate the amount of hours that I'll put into a car, before leading up to a race, just checking everything on the car, continuously trying to improve the tune-up to make sure the car's working as efficiently as possible, practicing my reaction times on the practice tree that I have at home, competing often. One of the things that is so crucial to being a good racer is seat time, Whenever I have the opportunity, I go out and I race, whether it's in Orlando, Bradenton, over in Clearwater, at Showtime Drag Strip. I've gone to West Palm Beach recently, just trying to get as many rounds under my belt as possible just to stay sharp, because it's not only about, especially in bracket racing, it's not just about doing a good reaction time, but then it's driving the finish line, making sure that you're making the right decisions at the right time, that you're not, passing two in front ahead of your competitor. You want to make it as tight as possible to minimize the chance of breaking out. So there's a lot of seat time that's required to keep honing in on your skills to go race at the higher level.
Exactly. Yeah. And you guys work a lot.
And he don't give up either.
And you never give up. That's the beauty of that. Never give up. Okay.
So I got a funny example. In the race in December, at the finals over at the import race in Orlando, the car had done, I had just put the brand new tires on. It was a cold day. The track was really sticky and the car did too big of a wheelie and actually came up off all four tires. broke the input shaft when it touched back down, and then the car just fell down and broke all sorts of things. It broke the transmission oil pan, the engine oil pan.
Oh, man.
There was a whole mess. And I actually had a Christmas party I was going to that day back in Tampa. So I was already committed to go to the party. So that all happened in Orlando. I loaded everything up, went to Tampa, finished the party, then came back to Orlando at 3 in the morning, worked till around 9, 10 in the morning inside the trailer, getting everything fixed. And then right before first round, when they called us down, I had everything ready, and I went to turn the car on, and the transmission wouldn't work because the actual input shaft had broken. I didn't know.
Oh, my goodness.
I changed the oil pan on the transmission. I put a bunch of epoxy on the engine oil pan, you know, just to start the leak enough for a day.
Yeah.
But I didn't know the input shaft was broken. So at the end of the day, I was there overnight working on the car. Thought I had everything ready, but, you know, it wasn't meant to be. But, yeah, if there's ever an opportunity, I assure you I will give 1,000% to try to make it back. And because you never know, you know, it could always be your day. So,
wow.
No se quita, no se quita el hombre, no se quita.
No se quita. That is great.
That's good. That means never give up. That's good.
Never give up. Yeah. And that's a great story, you know. This is a wonderful story.
Yeah, he's going to the party, but he can't forget about his race car.
No.
His race car suffered.
Trust me, I was sweating it a little bit, you know, but, you know, I've had crazy situations where, you know, if you just show up, anything could happen, you know?
Exactly.
And unfortunately, that day, the car was broke. I didn't have time to take the transmission out and change the input shaft. But, you know, it's just stuff that happens. You know, sometimes it works out for you and sometimes it doesn't. But the important thing is to stay positive and keep working hard and just set goals for yourself. You know, my goal this year is to compete against the V8s. I'm actually running the points chase in the regular points events in Orlando against the V8s.
Okay.
I'm currently in fourth place in the no box category. So my goal that I set for this year is to, obviously I'd like to win, but at least to finish in the top three of the points chase throughout the year. So,
okay.
You know, that's my short-term goal. And obviously when we go up to that $500,000 to win race in April, it wouldn't be bad to be able to win that one as well, as you could imagine.
No, that'll be good. That'll be real good for you if you get that.
Oh, my God. I mean, there's going to be like 600-some cars. They did a similar race last year, and I think for the main event, which was a $500,000 to win as well, I think the car count was like 640 cars.
Holy, so, that's a lot.
Okay.
Yeah, and the first round took like 5 hours to do.
Okay. Man, that's well.
And that's not import style where it takes, you know, 2 days to run 50 cars.
Yeah.
Like, this is just run after run after
run.
There's just so many cars. It's crazy.
Yeah.
No, your mind has to be ready for that. You don't want to.
Definitely, you're going
to
need a lot of stamina. You need
everything.
Okay, Ed. Yeah. I know this is going to be wonderful, and I know you commit. You know, you have a commitment with race and your car, with your team.
We are
so proud of you. So
keep up the good work.
Keep, exactly. And just say goodbye to everybody who's listening to you and this wonderful story that you just said.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. And thank you guys for, you know, giving exposure to the sport that we all love. You know, that's really important to make sure that the fans stay involved, they're pumped up, they come to the races.
Yeah.
You know, because if the events go well, the tracks are happy, the racers are happy because the tracks pay out good.
Exactly.
And, you know, it's a win-win for everybody. So thank you guys very much for what you do. It's very necessary, and I'm glad that you guys are there to do it.
Thank you.
Un besito bien grande para toda tu familia. Okay.
Dale, gracias, igualmente.
Okay, kisses for...
Gracias, bye. Gracias.
Ese fue nuestro Ed Núñez, right here, okay. Okay, ahora vamos a hablar con... Ay, teníamos ahí cerquitita a Mariteri. Mariteri, teníamos a Mariteri en la línea, pero por favor, danos una llamadita de nuevo que se tumbó la llamada.
Peche,
Pablo Álamo,
Peche, saludos, Peche.
Saludos a Peche por ahí.
Saludo
tenemos
a
Erika Luciano, que también está por ahí. Ramos, a Macho, Juan R. Ramos también está por ahí. Macho también.
El taxi, ¿verdad? Saludo al taxi.
El taxi también. ¿Qué te puedo decir? Bueno, tenemos la llamadita ahí, vamos a cogerla, ahí? Vamos a ver quién es. Adelante, estás en el aire. Buenos días. Hello. Sí, hello.
Hello.
No, un de nuevo, a lo mejor.
Hello.
Sí, ahora.
Hello.
¿Me escuchan?
Claro que sí, que te escuchamos muy bien, Mariteri. ¿Cómo estás? Bienvenida a Revoluciones por Minuto.
Bien, de aquí. Estamos bien, gracias a Dios. Qué estamos bueno. En periodo de recuperación, pero estamos bien.
Qué bueno, eso qué vale. Bueno, eso vale. Y siempre Mariteri, fíjate que Mariteri siempre nos acompaña a, bueno, nos acompañaba a los
races. A todo, donde quiera.
A todo, siempre ella está ahí, siempre pensando en Revoluciones por Minuto, porque esta es otra fiebrúa que no se quita.
De la mata, de la
claro
mata.
Que sí.
Seguro que no me quito y no me quitaré tampoco. Tenemos algo ahí pendiente, unos proyectitos que venimos con mi chica Erika, pero ya pronto tendremos noticias de
eso.
Eso vale. Exacto.
Mariteri, ¿eh?
No te veo, Mariteri, no te escucho. No se escucha, así es que, pues, no se está escuchando bien. Tenemos otra llamadita por ahí.
A ver,
vamos a coger la otra llamadita. Aló, adelante, estás en el aire. Hello, buenos días.
Hello.
Sí,
José. Hola, buenos días. Adola Tato Hernández.
¡Tato!
¡Ave María! ¿Cómo tú estás?
Todo bien, pero espérate, porque tú yo hablé ya el weekend pasado y este va a hablar Edwin Colón, que está aquí al lado en una reunión, para que aproveche, espérate.
¡Ave María! ¡Pero qué fantástico!
En el aire.
¡Oh, sí! Sí, ¡bienvenido a Revoluciones por Minuto! Oye, un aplauso para el boss.
Casi no te oye, estoy bien lejos.
El señor Edwin Colón, lo tenemos aquí en línea. Adelante, Edwin, ¿cómo estás? Bienvenido.
Tato y yo hablando un rato, pues, ¿qué te puedo contar? Parece que el timing de nosotros es muy bueno, porque ya para diciembre del año pasado lo prometido se cumplió, que fue el tener todos los récords mundiales de todos los imports. Me explico, 2 rotores, 3 rotores, 4 pistones y 6 pistones.
¡Wow!
Y entonces también habíamos dicho que estábamos interesados en entrar en la manufactura. Okay. Y estamos diciendo eso porque estamos diciendo que el que manufactura controla y el que no manufactura no controla.
Es correcto.
Así que se hizo una inversión seria, económica, en equipo de CNC, EDM, Wire EDM.
Ajá.
En el software que se llama SolidWorks. Y el chiste es que básicamente empezamos a hacer las piezas y empezaron a llegar proyectos externos en los cuales nos piden con urgencia que hagamos X o Y cosas. Entre ellas te puedo decir que estamos bregando con el telescopio de Arecibo.
Wow.
Con unas piezas que necesitan después del huracán María.
Okay.
Y entonces próximamente pues estamos en el diseño de la céntrica, que es el problema que tenemos con los 3 rotores.
Okay.
Fuera de eso, pues no vamos a estar corriendo. Y nos invitan y nos dicen que vayamos, pues puede que vayamos, pero sinceramente no es la prioridad. Todos los muchachos están concentrados en hacer piezas y luego comenzar a venderla.
Okay. ¿Cómo está funcionando esto? ¿Cómo surge la idea de que el señor Edwin Colón se pone a fabricar piezas? ¿De dónde?
No te escuché, perdóname otra vez.
¿Cómo surge la idea de la fabricación de piezas?
Bueno, lo que pasa es que dentro del currículo de Mercedes tenemos 3 departamentos, uno es el de transportación, que es el que casi todo el mundo conoce, que son las mecánicas, pero tenemos uno de salud y tenemos uno de manufactura. Dentro del de manufactura, pues siempre la idea de los carros de carrera, usted sabe muy bien que son laboratorios para nosotros. Tenemos un curso de mecánica racing y dentro de la mecánica racing ya tenemos la data de cómo correr lo mismo tiempo de los carros de carrera de nosotros, con la humedad, la temperatura.
Okay.
Cuánto era el peso, cuánto se dio de bus, etcétera, etcétera, qué computadora se utilizó. Y puedo anunciar hoy que la compañía FuelTech y cualquier otra compañía, y la ProLine, llegaron a un acuerdo con MechTech. Próximamente vamos a estar, además de MicroTech y de los otros sistemas, pues vamos a estar dando a este FuelTech en laboratorio y en certificaciones. Así que eso viene gracias a la Corvette. Que la Corvette se diseñó, básicamente vamos a estar corriendo Outlaw y buscando buenos tiempos ahí.
¡Wow! Oye, eso es tremendo. Tremendo que esas dos compañías se hayan unido, ¿verdad?
Eso es así. ¿Sí?
Oh, my
goodness.
Sí,
por sí creo que Isaiah estaba trabajando con el carro y llegó segundo este fin de semana, como haciendo prácticas.
Okay.
Y es un mundo de conocimiento, y vamos a hablar claro, lo que vamos a tratar de romperse los récords si tiene algunos motex. Y para eso pues contrataron a Mectec.
Oh, estás fantástico. Bueno, pues muchísimas gracias por siempre ponernos al día. Sabemos que vamos a correr en un futuro, vamos a estar corriendo, ¿verdad que sí? Que vamos, todo el mundo me llame y me pregunta.
Lo más seguro, no vaya a pasar mucho.
Ajá.
Además de eso, pues espero en Dios de que esta situación de coronavirus no nos afecte a ninguno de nuestros conocidos ni queridos.
Okay.
Pero cuando tú ves que el mundo se va al pandemonio, que es algo bien serio, y yo, por ejemplo, me voy a tener que guardar unos cuantos días con Falito en Salinas.
Exacto.
Vamos a sufrir mucho él y yo allí.
Okay.
La playa, el botecito. Va a ser bien difícil para nosotros.
La mezclita. Y la mezclita.
Y la mezclita.
Ya tú sabes, hay que tener la garganta todo el tiempo, vamos a hacer todas las instrucciones y nosotros vamos a seguir la piedra de la letra estos 15 días.
Muchísimas gracias, nos señor Colón.
Gracias. Okay, gracias.
Muchas gracias. Muchas gracias. Bueno, y tenemos, por ahí sigue Tato, ¿no? Ya, espérate. Estamos, ¿verdad? Seguimos. Okay,
Mata, también estamos vamos hablando de Carl Brenner, pero también hay que felicitar a Veneno.
A Veneno. A Veneno. Oye, 567-261
sí. Por poner la bandera en alto allí
sí.
En el evento.
Saludos Veneno a ellos. Racing, 567, ¿ah? ¿A 200 cuántas?
12-1.
261 millas.
Y por que, lo que da eso, oye, muchachos.
Muchas gracias, oye, por esos tiempos. Tenemos a alguien en línea. Adelante, estás en el aire. Hello.
Hola, buenas tardes. Buenos días, Magda. Soy yo, Gloria.
Hola, ¿cómo estás, Gloria? Bueno, Gloria.
Perdida en la sémora. No puedo creerlo. Yeah.
No, eso le pasa a Gloria.
No, es que me quitaron el letrero amarillo. Yo, María, letrero amarillo. María me dice, yo no veo letrero amarillo. Yo, ay, Dios mío, ¿de qué color será?
Pero en
de
la
todos
construcción.
Modos, estoy siendo presente. Te voy a dar las gracias a todos por darme la oportunidad de poder expresarme y saludar a todo el público de ustedes.
Okay.
Claro. Y nada, excusarme que no pude llegar a tiempo.
Pero vamos a tener una premisa al público que, pues, la próxima semana, pues, te vamos a tener aquí en vivo, ¿verdad que sí? Así
perfecto,
es que
perfecto.
Hay tremenda noticia que Gloria nos va a
válgate.
Dar y que somos los primeros en que la vamos a divulgar por aquí, por el bejuco. ¿Ah? Por aquí. Así es que...
Mira, entonces no había tráfico, ¿verdad? Y cuando voy a doblar, demasiado de mucho tráfico. Van a decir que es mentira mía porque las calles están vacías. No, aquí sí en Altamonte hay mucho tráfico.
Ok, bueno. Gloria, pues entonces nos vemos la próxima semana y gracias, ¿oíste?
Ay, mi amor, gracias a usted y disculpe nuevamente, pero me quitaron el letrero amarillo.
Okay.
Así que los quiero y saludo a todo tu público y feliz día y muchas gracias y disculpa que no pude llegar a tiempo.
No te gracias. Preocupes que tenemos la semana que vean te pillamos, no te preocupes.
Pues gracias, un besote.
Okay,
bye, los quiero, bye.
Vamos a tomar la próxima llamada. Adelante, estás en el aire. Buenos días.
Hello, yo otra vez por aquí.
Bueno, oh, Mariteri, yo te aconsejo que como que te quedes ahí, rapidito ahí.
No te muevas.
Ahí, rapidito, Mariteri.
Me quedé sin señal. Mira, Mata, estaba llamando para, sobre todas las cosas, darle las gracias por todo lo que siempre hacen y me apoyan. Sabes que estoy en un periodo de recuperación por mi operación. Gracias a que todo salió bien.
Qué bueno.
Y hay Mariteri para rato.
Eso vale. Gracias, Mariteri. Gracias.
También quería hacerte el acercamiento, como estuvimos hablando en el día de ayer, que pongamos mucho en oración a Tatiana.
Sí, que ella tuvo un accidente, fíjate, sabemos que tuvo un accidente.
Tatiana, ¿sí?
Sí, Tatiana tuvo un accidente grave.
Ay, Dios mío.
Entonces, bendito. Ella está muy, pero que muy delicada. Ay, y Dios. Vamos a ver que la próxima semana, pues, me llamas con tiempo y a lo mejor te tengo aquí ese sábado para ver que estamos planeando unas cositas para ayudarla, ¿ok?
Pues seguro que sí, Tatiana, gracias a Dios ya está más estable. Ustedes saben que ella pues ha sido parte de nuestra familia también en esto de la fiebre, pero yo sé que ella se va a levantar de esa cama y de la misma forma que me han levantado a mí y nuestra familia ha pasado muchas, pues, un poquito situaciones difíciles. De esta vez okay. Vamos a volver a ver a Tatiana de pie.
Perfecto, Mariteri, pues muchísimas gracias.
Gracias.
Despídete del público. Rapidito.
Ok, los quiero mucho, espero que sigamos como siempre adelante y sobre todas las cosas que celebremos este mes con estos años que ustedes han tenido ahí luchando y trabajando fuerte para mantener al público y a todos informados.
Muchas gracias. Esa fue nuestra amiga Mari Terry. Una bulla, muchachos. Una bulla ahí para la Mari Terry. Bueno, gracias. Bueno, saluditos rapiditos. Tenemos que darle saludos aquí a Leonardo Marrero. Saludos, mi gente buena. Magdi Bombi, saludos de corazón. Y tenemos por ahí a Wilmer Olmedo que dice...
Wilmito, saludos. También tengo por aquí Gary White, 663, Texas 2K. Felicidades a él. Tengo a Mario Rayham, 13B, Automatic World Record, 705. Joel Grana, 705, 200 millas por hora, 6P World Record, quickest H-pattern in the world. Speedy Performance en la isla, Supra MK5, 975, turbo y de fábrica y sin nitro. Speedy Performance.
Ok, bueno, señoras y señores, ahora pasando al calendario de eventos rapidito porque no tenemos mucho tiempo. Ha sido cancelado las Gator Nationals, canceladas. Otro evento más que fue cancelado por el coronavirus es la NASCAR, fue cancelada. También el Festival Import de las Américas, cancelado. Otro evento por ahí, Luis Felipe, que tenemos también. Las escuelas están cerradas, todo esto por el coronavirus, lo que le indicamos, la NASCAR, ya lo mencioné también, que están cerrados hasta pleno, al próximo aviso, ¿verdad? Que ellos digan. Que no se armen la gente, no todo lo que hay, por favor, así que dejen cosas para otras personas. Y a buscar muchas cosas a inclusive al Publix, y no estaban. También hoy les exhorto que Publix va a estar, oye, ¿qué nos pasó ahí? Que vamos a las millas. Cierra temprano hoy Publix.
Yeah, 1 hour
así
early,
que
I think it
llega
is.
Temprano yeah. A comprar tus cosas. ¿Qué más? Bueno, mantenerse safe, señoras y señores.
Y
mantengan un team, ¿ok? Los números de teléfonos, pásenselos. A toda tu familia, pasa el número de teléfono donde te pueden encontrar,
hay
por
que
si
bañarse,
acaso
hay que
no
bañarse,
podemos salir.
Hay
okay?
que bañarse.
También, qué funny. Eso lo sabemos.
Saludos a Domi, qué es lo que, no bulto.
Ay, cabrón.
Sí, para mi gente dominicana, saludos.
Bueno, Alex, muchísimas gracias por todo tu apoyo y por todo el trabajo bueno que estás haciendo aquí con nosotros. A todos nuestros radio escucha, muchísimas gracias. Thank you very much for listening for 18 years.
Yeah,
right,
the radio
here
show, yep.
And Radio RPM, okay?
Thanks, Carl Burnett, for calling the show. Thanks exactly. For everybody for calling in, and God bless. Thank you.
See you next time.
WONQ Oviedo, Orlando.